The skimmer and return ports on a vinyl liner swimming pool are a very likely place that can develop a leak over time. So if you're doing an inspection of a vinyl liner pool, this is an area that you definitely want to pay a lot of attention to. Now, with a skimmer mouth, it's right near the top of the water level, so it's something that you can inspect very readily. And as mentioned in a prior video, the first thing you want to do is just check the wall surface itself directly surrounding the skimmer. Is there any feel or evidence that there might be rust growing underneath the liner? And if that's the case, it's probably an indication that there's been a long-term leak in this location, something that might require some extra attention when it comes time to renovate this pool next. Now, the skimmer itself is a compression gasket, and the screws that are there all must be there and all must be compression tight. And what that means is, if you're looking at a skimmer and you notice, well, there seems to be a screw missing here, but it looks okay. I mean, everything seems tight. Nothing should be leaking, right? Wrong. It's probably leaking. In fact, I almost guarantee it's leaking. Those screw holes are there for a reason, and there needs to be a screw in it. And depending on the type of skimmer that you have, a lot of times you can have a problem with it that doesn't really reveal itself until the final stages of a new liner installation. So literally you're at the point where everything else has been done. It's perhaps even the final screws that get turned into the skimmer faceplate that end a vinyl liner renovation project. And if you're turning those screws and you find out, oh, one of them's just spinning, what'll happen with a lot of installers, unfortunately, is that they'll just leave it. Especially if that screw is above the water line, they figure, well, it's probably okay, right? I mean, it probably is right now. It might not even be a problem this season, but I guarantee that that is going to allow water to get behind the liner in a way that it's not supposed to, and it's definitely going to increase the rate of rust happening in that area. And the more that the rust grows, the more it's going to perpetuate the problem, and the bigger the leak's going to get. At the end of the day, if there's a screw that's not installed or it's spinning freely, even if it's above the waterline, it's going to vastly reduce the longevity and service life of this liner that's just been installed. This is something that needs to be addressed for sure. Now, there's a lot of ways that you can actually fix this on the fly, so there's really no reason for it, but in terms of the inspection itself, all you're really looking for is, are all the screws there and are all of them tight? And if you don't own the property, you really can't use a screwdriver and check to see if they're all tight, because sometimes doing that could be a problem. That screw could be hanging on by the skin of its teeth, and you go to touch it, now you're the reason why that screw is spinning and potentially the cause for a leak. So not something you want to go and do. So in terms of this inspection for skimmers and faceplates, you just want to do a visual inspection, see if anything looks funny to you, and then of course check the wall around the flange itself and see if there's any indication of rust. Now, when it comes to the return flanges themselves, it's a little bit different. Return flanges break in a very specific way. Basically, they get over-tightened. There's four screws usually, and what you're looking for is stress fractures where those four screws are located. As the faceplate gets older, those stress fractures will become more prominent to the point where the return flange will start to break away one quarter piece at a time, with the four screws that are there being too tight. It cracks in those four locations and then breaks into four individual pieces. At that point, of course, there's going to be a pretty extensive leak happening in that location, and something that's going to need to be attended to at the time that a new vinyl liner is installed. Now, the significance of the return faceplate is that return faceplates are typically replaced when a vinyl liner is replaced. So just by looking at the faceplate itself, not only can you tell how old the faceplate is, but you're also inferring how old the liner itself is. So if I were inspecting a vinyl liner pool and I were looking at skimmer and returns, that's what I'm looking for, is I'm looking for any rust or indication that the screws aren't installed correctly, or any cracks around the screws from stress cracks from the screws being too tight. And then I guess in terms of the skimmer body itself, of course, you need to do a thorough inspection down inside the skimmer body and inside the skimmer mouth and throat. And all you're looking for is cracks. There should be no cracks at all, obviously. Any cracks in a vinyl liner swimming pool, a vinyl liner swimming pool skimmer is going to be a problem, because you can't replace the vinyl liner swimming pool skimmer unless you replace the liner also. So it's definitely something to watch out for. The last thing you want to do is purchase a pool that has a relatively new liner on it, but a problem with the skimmer that might result in you purchasing another new liner for it. So that's what I would look for if I was inspecting skimmers and returns on a vinyl liner swimming pool.